Welcome to Movie in Brief. Today, I will explain the 2016 movie, Passengers. The film begins in outer space, where the spaceship Avalon, on autopilot, is en route to the Homestead II colony world during a mass exodus of Earth's population. The crew and 5,000 passengers are all put to sleep for the 120-year journey. 30 years have passed since the trip. The ship passes through a meteor storm and the current is sent to the front shield, then the ship hits a large meteor and the power flashes, the red warning lights in the control area light up, then quickly returns to normal. Something bad happened. Mechanical engineer Jim Preston, Chris Pratt, is awakened in his cell by a cheerful computer voice telling him that they will soon arrive in Homestead 2. She is told that it is normal to feel confused and weak after resting. His wrist is scanned and the computer guides him to the cabin where he sleeps. The next day, she wakes up, tries to decide what to wear when meeting her fellow travelers, then goes to a cafe where she is alone. He goes to an orientation class about the life of a farmer, but he is the only one there. The gleeful CGI director doesn't understand her question as to why no one else is there. Jim goes to the main concert and gets no help from the information kiosk. He finds an office where he can send a message to the Homestead company that he will be warned dearly. He sends a message explaining that he is the only one awake and in need of help, then discovers that it will be 15 years before anyone on Earth receives his message. He is alone. Jim finds manuals for all the equipment of the ship. He examines the hibernation guide, but can't find a way to restart it after the person woke up. He cannot enter the area where the team's fires are intended to wake someone up for help, and he cannot enter the command area. His wrist doesn't give him the right amount of space. Jim finds a fake bartender named Arthur, Michael Sheen, to interact with, but the android is programmed to give bartender advice, like moving if you don't like it. That. Jim is an economy class traveler with modest accommodations and amenities. A year passes as Jim takes advantage of the ship's entertainment facilities, but without other people he becomes increasingly lonely. He goes to an area where passengers can safely put on spacesuits attached to the ship and go outside. Jim considers killing himself by opening the airlock without his spacesuit, but stops and runs into the cell. He stumbles near a fire with a beautiful woman, Aurora Lane, Jennifer Lawrence, inside. He goes through her passenger profile, which he saved before the ship left. He is a reporter and travels to Kajitalu to have an adventure and learn why people choose settlements. He reads her stories and thinks she is perfect. He struggles with himself to wake her, knowing that it will condemn him to death on the ship, but he cannot bear to be alone for a year, so he makes her wake him by hand, hiding before he sees her. The same cheerful computer program wakes Aurora up and puts her to sleep in her cabin. Aurora wakes up alone the next day and travels to a big concert where she meets Jim. He tells her the truth about how long he was awake, but he doesn't tell her that he is awake. He asks the android bartender Arthur not to tell Aurora what he did, and Arthur agrees. Aurora and Jim talk every day, discuss what to do to fight the fires. Aurora swims, runs, and begins to write her story. He asks why Jim left planet Earth and he says he likes to make and fix things and on Earth things are replaced when they break and aren't fixed. He wants to live in a house that he is building himself. His plan was to travel to the colony, spend a year there talking to the colonists about why they left Earth, and then return to Earth. Aurora is a gold-class passenger and uses her status to receive more elaborate breakfasts than her normal pass requires. After getting to know each other, Jim asks Aurora on a date and she accepts. After eating, he takes her to the dressing room in space and there are two suits and they both get dressed and go out. Back inside, Aurora is excited and they go to Jim's cabin to make love. They are happy, practicing their routines, stargazing, taking advantage of the ship's entertainment and restaurant facilities. Another year passes and it's Aurora's birthday, and Jim plans a special surprise, made her a ring. Going to the bar, Aurora tells Arthur that she and Jim have no secrets, and Jim agrees, not realizing that Arthur interprets this to mean that Jim told Aurora that he woke her up. Jim enters the men's room and Arthur tells Aurora what a good choice Jim made to wake her up. Aurora is shocked and furious and tells Jim to stay away from her. One night he enters her cabin while she is sleeping and attacks her with his fists. As they run, Jim uses the ship's intercom to explain, but Aurora screams that Jim took her life. As all this goes on, the control room receives more and more reports of system failures over time. Jim and Aurora noticed little things like system glitches in the cleaning robots. It's been 2 years since the meteor hit. One day Gus Mancuso, Lawrence Fishburne, wakes up and appears in the hall. He is the head of the deck crew and he is an early riser. Hibernation pods have never failed before and he explains that something is wrong. His wrist takes them to the control center, where they discover that the automatic diagnostics of the ship have failed and they must manually control each deck. Although Gus conducts experiments before this can be done, a severe gravity failure occurs and Aurora nearly sinks into the pool. Gus notices that there have been failures and the computer is able to create a timeline that shows the first failure was 2 years earlier. Gus concludes that the first few failures were caused by power outages to balance the load, but the load became too heavy, causing more and more failures. The whole ship is in danger of dying in space, destroying all the crew and passengers. At first the damaged area was in the main engine area, but they have to do a manual check to find out where. At this point, Gus collapses and Jim and Aurora take him to the hospital and put him in the hospital. Medical van diagnostic scanner. He has multiple gangrenes in his body and death is imminent due to hibernation dysfunction. He puts on his uniform and prepares to die, giving Jim and Aurora armbands to access the areas of the ship where they need to go to fix things. While planning, Jim and Aurora find a hole made by a meteorite that examines some critical areas. When they open one of the doors, Aurora is nearly sucked through the frame. He attaches it to the tablet that Jim shoves to him, and Jim uses liquid sealant to further seal the hole. The area becomes pressurized and then they learn that the exhaust from the fusion engine must be manually vented. Manual transmission doesn't work, Jim has to put on a space suit and go outside to fix it. He has to go into the exhaust to open the valve, but it won't stay open unless Jim holds it open for the manual vent to work. Aurora argues with him on the radio, desperate not to lose Jim, but pulls the lever. Jim is pushed out, his belt breaks and there is a hole in his suit. He says goodbye to Aurora. He runs to put on the space suit himself and goes to find her. He picks Jim up by the leash, but when they enter, he doesn't answer. He drags him to the hospital and the doctor says that Jim is dead. Aurora uses the bracelet and his bypass of Gus to revive Jim on the machine and it works. He's alive and he's relieved and happy. Later on the ship, things went back to normal. Jim works on the automated document and tells Aurora that he learned that by defeating the commando he could put her back into hibernation in the hospital, but she would be alone again. Realizing that she will never see Jim again, Aurora decides to stay awake with him and live with him on the ship. He gives her a temporary engagement ring he made earlier, which she accepts. 88 years later. The journey is over and the captain and crew wake up and arrive at a large clearing to find a huge tree, lots of vines and vegetation, flying birds, and a cabin, which may contain Jim and Aurora. Grandchildren. Aurora's speech is reading his story to the travelers and explaining how they made a good life where they were.